Now that all but one of the Kalis files has been revealed, it's time to look over everything we know about the Bat Monsters, their biology, and yes, the movie that possibly inspired the game's enemies. We've had a lot of good looks at the monster now, so we can confidently describe what it looks like. About 8 feet tall when fully standing, a set of spines protruding from its back, leathery wings which stretch from its arms to its torso, a second set of wings protruding from in the middle of its back, big teeth right at the front of its mouth, long claws in its front and back legs. It's capable of making both clicking sounds to echolocate, and also loud screeches, which may be a form of communication among the bat monsters. Now let's go into their biology a little. They're nocturnal, likely because the sun damages them to the point where their flesh burns, and continuous powerful light can cause them to burst into flame entirely. They likely hibernate for long periods of time and emerge from the depths to feed periodically. Notably, all of the reports of them feeding on local livestock come from winter months, suggesting that they either prefer the cold or are just more active when the nights are longer. They're famously so sensitive to sunlight that they're most likely to hunt on moonless nights, which makes me wonder if the scene I've predicted, in which the heroes make it out of the pit and get attacked by the monsters during an eclipse, is even possible, since eclipses tend not to be anywhere near as dark as a moonless night. Then again, if the monsters are incredibly angry, maybe they'll charge out into the eclipse-dimmed surface and just deal with the pain. They seem to need to eat, given the livestock stripped of their organs and the fact that the autopsy report refers to their skin as covered in excretions, suggesting that, like bats, these monsters may live surrounded by their own filth. We have no idea what their lifespan might be, only that there are clear records of their existence going back nearly 100 years, and stories about them dating back into antiquity. Of course, there's no way to officially tell yet if these are the exact same monsters, or if they're reproducing somehow. The fact that they have 4 wings seems particularly significant, according to an archaeologist who was kind enough to comment on one of my videos. Since the Akkadian people associated sky with their gods, birds were frequently thought of as holy, as they traveled through the sky. A huge number of their gods are bird-themed, and it was normal for them to depict gods as having wings, to cement their association with the sky and heaven, exactly like how angels are depicted as having wings, to draw the same associations with flight and heaven. Is the game suggesting that the 4-wing formation we see on the Pazuzu statue and in various stelae are the people of Akkad referencing this monster's body? That's certainly the implication. Now we have the big question that needs to be answered. Where do they come from? We're not going to get into whether they're magical, i.e. a curse by the gods of Akkad on Naram Sin, or whether they're mundane, i.e. an undiscovered subterranean creature. We don't have any information that speaks to this yet, so we'll put a pin in it for now and come back when we know more. Instead, I'm going to focus on a theory that fits with the game's themes and the mythological creature the monster most resembles, the vampire. There are 2 big possibilities here. One, that the creatures reproduce by growing new monsters inside human bodies, like the aliens from the movie Aliens. Or the second possibility, which I find more likely, that the bat monsters are deformed mutant humans, and that humans can be transformed into them after being infected by one of the bat monsters. Maybe via a bite, maybe through a more complicated method. Remember the reference to the monster's saliva in the Hodgson Expedition book? Could that have been a reference to diseased or infectious saliva? There's only 2 clues suggesting this first theory. 1. The fact that one of the tracks in the official soundtrack is called Cocoons, which brings to mind what happens to people the aliens in Aliens grab. And 2. This punctured skull secret, which has teeth missing at the front, suggesting that something burst out from inside its mouth. Could this headburster effect be how the little monsters are born? The second theory has a little more evidence, although some of it is a reach. First off is the skull, which can be read in 1 of 2 ways. The autopsy and concept art we've seen both mentions and focuses on the giant front teeth as an especially notable part of the creature's anatomy. Maybe this human's teeth are missing and its skull is warped because when it died, it was partway through the transformation from man into beast. Next, we have another possible definition of cocoon, which is the chrysalis that caterpillars make when they're transforming from one thing into another. Perhaps the bat monsters grab humans, infect them, and then excrete a substance that wraps them in a cocoon while their bodies go through the transformation into bat creatures. I lean towards this theory because it ties in with the idea that I had, that the vampire may, in fact, be a partially transformed human who has the bat monster's strength and longevity, but never fully transformed into one. My earlier concept was that the monsters could transform back and forth from human to bat creature, which would be said to have inspired that part of vampire mythology. But given how grounded the dark pictures tend to be, that might be a stretch for something they'd be willing to show. So, what does the word cocoon mean in the way the game is using it? Are the humans cocooned like a spider's prey, or like a moth waiting to fly? Either way, I wouldn't be shocked to find out that after her dramatic abduction at the start of the game, Clarice showed up in the third act as an instantly recognizable victim of the cocooning process, whatever it winds up being. Personally, I can't wait to see what's hidden in the nest below the temple. Before we get into the movie that I suspect partially inspired the creatures, I'd like to drill down on one line in the autopsy report that seems extremely significant. The creature also is formed of an unidentified tissue and appears to be decomposing. Obviously, the unidentified tissue bit speaks for itself. They've never seen anything like it. But what does appears to be decomposing mean? It can't mean this dead thing we're cutting up is decomposing, because that's the nature of dead things. Every corpse that has an autopsy performed on it is decomposing. So I'd suggest that this means the creature was already dead when it was killed and the body was brought back for research. How is that possible? There are two obvious options. One, it's a magical thing, and the bat creatures are what we call undead. This ties in with the vampire origin story. They're living corpses that have to feed on blood and flesh to keep their existence going. Under this theory, the character I've been calling the vampire would literally be a vampire. Two, it's a parasite, like the regenerators from Resident Evil 4. In case you're not familiar with the regenerators, they're corpses that are infected with a mutated form of the Las Plagas parasite that caused the outbreak in that game. Essentially, the parasite wants to feed and reproduce, so a cluster of them inhabit and puppeteer a corpse, moving it around to attack victims, feeding, and spreading itself. I know that sounds like a regular zombie, but the difference in the regenerator is that they have the ability to repair their host body from nearly any amount of damage. The parasites keep it alive indefinitely, and only by damaging the parasites can you kill it. What if these monsters are essentially zombies being puppeteered by parasites? Now we're going way into sci-fi territory here, but please bear with me. Let's say there's a parasite that needs a bunch of blood to survive and breed, but it wasn't good hunting and killing things for food. What if it adapted to take over humans and transform them into what it understands as the best form to collect the blood it needs to survive? In this case, hideous bat monsters. Under this theory, the character I call the vampire would be a human infected with the parasites who, for whatever reason, was unable to be fully converted into a bat monster, leaving him as a walking corpse who constantly needs more blood to feed the parasites that keep him alive. Still basically a vampire, but more like the vampire in Guillermo del Toro's movie Kronos than a traditional mythological vampire. Seriously, how good is Kronos? Now, let's get into the movie that may have inspired House of Ashes, and definitely inspired my conviction that the creatures are mutated humans who are transformed by a parasite. It's not Kronos, although you should definitely watch that if you haven't. It's not The Descent, either. Yes, that is a movie about exploring caves and finding blind mutant humans in the depths. And Supermassive have specifically name-checked it as an inspiration. But I'm looking to something a little more obscure that they didn't mention. Despite some obvious similarities, which is completely understandable after all, if there was a movie out there with a plot that, possibly entirely coincidentally, gave away a bunch of plot points of their game, they'd never mention it, out of fear of spoiling surprises for their audience. Now, before I mention the movie in question, I want to note that if I wind up being right about this, it's a pretty big spoiler. So fair warning, if you don't want to risk that, stop watching now, after liking and subscribing, of course. Okay, ready? The movie I'm talking about is 2005's The Cave. This movie made a bit of a stir upon its release because of its similarities to The Descent. The films are actually quite different, but The Cave suffered in comparison because people really liked The Descent, and it came out a month earlier. The Cave starts with a church built hundreds of years ago on a site of a battle between the armies of man and subterranean demons. Some thieves attempt to blast their way into a cave beneath the church, hoping to find hidden treasure. But instead, they're attacked by creatures that fly in the darkness and make strange clicking sounds. Years later, researchers discover the cave system and want to map it out, thinking that it could be an isolated ecosystem full of unique animals adapted to living in total darkness. A team of researchers, cave divers, and rock climbers head into the cave system, then find themselves beset by monsters, and they're forced to fight for their life as they try to escape. Over the course of their ordeal, they discover that the legendary battle between the armies of men and demons was based on a true story, in which a horde of creatures had to be beaten back into the caves, at which point the humans triggered a landslide, trapping the creatures beneath the earth, and then built a church on top of it to warn people about the danger below. The second thing they learn is that the creatures that live underneath the earth aren't simply some strangely evolved predators. They're actually mutated humans who have been turned into a host by a parasite that lives in the cave. Once people are infected, it starts to transform them until they've become the very thing that attacked them in the first place. The kicker? This is what the movie's demons look like. Seem familiar? Long legs and arms with claws at the end, wings that attach at the torso, prominent fangs, a big sturdy-looking head, and an array of spines protruding from the back. Take out the big hollow bony plate from the top of its head, and the resemblance is uncanny. That said, if you tell multiple character designers, "I need a scary half-man, half-bat creature," there's a good chance you're going to get a whole bunch of things that look surprisingly close to that. Heck, the Cloverfield monster was just a giant vampire bat with the wing skin removed. Still, if my theory is correct and the bat monsters are mutated humans, then in all likelihood the people at Supermassive Games are at least aware of the cave, if not partially inspired by it. So, to recap. The most likely theory as of now is that the monsters are mutant humans which have been transformed into strange bat creatures. There's a possibility that they infect people by biting them, to reinforce the whole vampire connection. And there's an outside chance that only the vampire we've seen in the few videos and pictures can actually turn people into monsters. No, there's no actual evidence for this yet, but from a writing standpoint, that would give the game an alpha level threat. And however it's ended, the players could be satisfied that the threat has been resolved so long as he's killed, no matter what happens with the rest of the characters. Of course, it's possible that I'm wrong about every single point I'm making here, since some of it got pretty weird. Did I just spend a minute explaining regenerators from Resident Evil 4? Waiting on this game might be driving me mad. I've been the Hidden Object Guru, thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please remember to like and subscribe. Special thanks to my patrons Marissa, Desire, Eduardo, Joanne, and Brian. If you'd like to support the channel so I can continue making videos like this one, check out the Patreon link. Anything is appreciated. If there's any topics about dark pictures or other subjects you'd like to see covered, be sure to mention them in the comment section below the video. See you back here for more dark pictures, but until then, au revoir.